Hello guys, my name is Siddhanshu Kapoor. I am your instructor. So today we talk about Azure Media Services. Azure provide you media services as well. Okay. So what is Azure Media Services? Let's start the lecture, guys. So if we talk about the media services, so media services means it gives you or it enables you to build. You can say that if you want to, if you want to encoding. If you want to packaging, like it is a cloud-based platform that enables you to build solutions that requires encoding, packaging, content protecting, and live streaming. Okay, live streaming. So the meaning of Azure Media Services is that, like imagine we are seeing so many videos on the YouTube also. We can see we have so many applications also who providing media services, like Netflix is one of the application, web application. Okay, who gives you so many videos. With the help of Netflix, you can see so many web series and all the stuffs. Okay, so what happens in when cloud platform is not there? If I want to upload my videos, or if I want to like YouTube. Like you can say that I like I have my net export channel. Okay, so I have all my videos. I can upload the videos, and then you people able to see the videos all over the world. Okay, with the help of internet. So what happens in that case if I don't have Azure platform, or if I don't have cloud platform? You can say that. So what happens? I need to build one physical server. Okay, and I can upload all my videos on that particular server, and then the server is automatic, and we need to connect that server with internet connection, and then be able to upload and publish the video on the Google and something else like this. Okay, so what happens in that case? Cloud gives you the platform. Azure Media Services gives you the platform. Okay, if you want to upload any video, so you don't need a dedicated server. Okay, we have a Azure Media Services platform. Okay, that gives you the platform. Okay, you can upload the videos. Okay, when you upload the videos automatically saves on Azure Cloud. Okay, like this. Okay, so like Netflix, YouTube. Okay, these are some companies who using cloud platform media services. Okay, who using media services? It doesn't want that they always use Azure. They use other cloud platforms also. Okay, it doesn't matter, but they use media services. Okay, so media services provide you a cloud platform where you can upload the content, where you can save all the videos, where you can go for live streaming. Okay, like we have option over there in live streaming also. You can go for live streaming also. Okay, so next point is that in Azure we are using AMS version 3. AMS means Azure Media Services version 3. Okay, so we are using version 3 in this. Okay, with the help of the services, we can upload videos and schedule videos also. Now, upload videos is understandable that we can upload the videos. Schedule means, like imagine I can upload one video on my channel. I want that this video is visible only for 7 days, not more than that. So we can schedule also that. Okay, after 7 days, what happens? The video is automatically deleted, or it's not publishable. Okay, or it's not published automatically, or 7 days, or 1 day, or 24 hours. You can see that, like I have one video, I want it. Okay, only 24 hours this video is available on my channel. Okay, after 24 hours the video is automatically unavailable. No one is able to access or see that particular video. Okay, so we can go for that with the help of Azure Media Services. Okay, now Azure Media Services provides you security and high scalable means you can say that you can add or remove the videos. Okay, you can remove the videos also, you can add the videos also. Okay, you can provide security also, like if you want to encrypt your videos, your content should be encryptable. Okay, or your content should be encrypted in format, so you can go for that. Okay, so AMS provides you these things. So right now Azure provides you AMS version 3. We are using AMS version 3 right now in Azure Media, in Azure platform. Okay, now the question is how we can configure AMS, Azure Media Services. So we have some requirements. If I want to configure Azure Media Services, so we need one AMS account. Number one, we need one AMS account. Number two, we need storage account. And number three, we need resource account, resource group. Okay, so we need to create these three things. Okay, AMS account, storage account and resource. Okay, so we need these three things to configure Azure Media Services. Okay, so let's start, guys. Let's start the practical of how we can configure Azure Media Services. Okay, so I just minimize this and I open my portal. So this is my portal. Okay, so if you can see that I have media services option is there. If you're not able to see the media services over there in your home page, okay, or in your home portal, so you just click on search and write down media. So they give you media services options over there. Okay, now simple click on media services. So first we need to create media services account. Okay, so I just click on add over there. Okay, just a minute, guys. Okay, so right now I just simple click on add. And then I'm going to create a media services account. Okay, so I give over there the account name is Kingo is it media one? I hope it's taking. No, it's not allowed. Lowercase only. Okay, I need to give lowercase only. Media is it? Azure Media One. Okay, now it's available. So my account name is AZ Media One. Now I am using trial subscription. Now I need to create a resource group also. So I'm going to create a new resource group. Click on create a new, and I'm going to create a new resource group. So my resource group name is AZ Media-RG. Okay, I choose this. Now I'm using the location East US over there. Okay, now I need to create a storage account as well also. Okay, so I just simply click on that. Okay, now I'm going to create a storage account, create a new account. Okay, now I need to give the storage account name. So this is ST01. I hope it's able to take. It's already taken. Okay, ST0RG storage. Storage 1 is taken, storage 100 also taken. Okay, so now my account is storage 56. Okay, I'm choosing storage version 2 because I want that it select all the storage, all the types of storage. Okay, and we can use LRS application. Okay, so because in our Azure Media Services we can only use LRS. Okay, we can use these three: LRS, DRS, and GRS. So LRS, local redundant storage, means so it replicate my local storage, my local location storage. It saves in East US only. Okay, so now I just going to click on this only. Simple. I go to create. Click on OK. So you can see that the storage account is going to create. It's the storage account name is storage 56. Okay, and now I'm going to create this media services. You can see the note. Please note that you can only choose LRS or read only access RS type to work with Azure Media Services. So I already told you that you can go for LRS storage account. Okay, so there we can able to create only three. Okay, which I already told you. Okay, so we can go for three. I'm sorry, just wait, please. Okay, so as you can see that we can be able to create only three: LRS, GRS, and RAGRS. Means geo geographical redundant storage we can able to see. We can able to replicate a local redundant storage also. So by default I'm choosing LRS. Okay, so it's showing you the same thing on the note also. Now you can see that it's showing you on the same thing on the note that we have LRS, GRS, and those types. Okay, so click on create after that. Simple click on create. It's going to create. Okay, so it's by submitting the file that I have sent that I have all rights to use the data, including all proper manner. Okay. Okay, online services. Okay, everything is fine. What happens? Just a minute, guys. Okay, so when we going to create this Azure BGP Media Service account, we need to accept this license. Okay, by submitting my file data, I represent that I have all the rights to use the data, including all proper contents and all those stuffs. Okay, so we need to accept this. Okay, and then simply click on create. Okay, so now it's going to create my media services account. Okay. So as you can see that the deployment is completed. Okay, so now I'm going to go back to home and click on media services again. As you can see that one media AZ Media One account is created. Okay, it's in AZ Media RG Group and it's under East US location. Okay, so now let's click on this. Click on AZ Media account. Now what I need to do, I am going to add one video in this. Okay, so how we can go for that? Okay, we need to go to down and we need to go to click on assets one. Click on assets. Over there I am going to upload my video. Okay, rather simple, click on upload. Okay, I need to submit it again. I need to just agree this. Okay, so I just accept this agreement and click on browse for files. Okay, so I'm using, imagine I'm use this. Okay, and click on open. Now it's uploading the video. It's in here about 1 MB something. Let's see. Let's upload the video first. Okay, so as you can see that the video is now added. Okay, now I need to publish this video. So how we can go for that? Now click on this video or your asset which you want to publish. Okay, now we have the option over there, publish. Okay, you can encode also first and then you can go for publish. Okay, so if you click on encode, so it's going to encode the video first. Okay, it's convert their size, their information, their assets. Okay, whatever they need, whatever syntax they need, it's automatically converted them, and then you need to go to publish. Okay, so simply click on create once. I'm going to encode this this video. Okay, after encode the video, you can see that encoded is successfully. Okay, and now I go for publish. Now click on publish over there. So when you're going to click on publish, okay, so they ask you for date and time, at what time and what date you want to publish. Okay, and like imagine I want only for like this, I want for today is 29th May, I go for 30th May till only. Okay, I go for 24 hours only. Okay, so it starts with 29th May and it's end with 30th May, like this. Okay, we can define this like this also. Okay, so I go for 24 hours only. So we click on add over there. Okay, so it's adding. So this video is published only for 24 hours. So now it's, you can see that this video is published now. Okay, so you just click on down over there and you have the option, this video, click on this. Okay, and you have the URL. We got the URL after that. After publish the video, you got the URL also. Just wait. Okay, as you can see that you got the URL. Okay, with the help of this URL, you're able to see the see this video. Okay, the size of this video is 1.14 MB. Okay, as you can see that we by default use blob storage in media services. Okay, so I copy this link. Okay, and I paste it over there and I enter it. Okay, so with the help of this, selects not give me. Okay, so it takes some time. Okay, after that it's showing it, with we can use this with the help of this link. With the help of this link we can able to see this video. Okay, so like this we can see that we can apply, we can add the video and we can publish the video. Okay, fine, it takes some time because you can see that it's refreshing the page right now. So let's go for that. Okay, so you can add multiple assets over there. Just click on that. We can upload multiple assets over there. Okay, right now I have only one asset, this video. We can add multiple assets like this. Okay, fine. Okay, so like this, we can go for that. Now we have more options also. like we can go for content protection also. You can click on content protection. So it's protect your content with the help of authorization policy. You can define the authorization policy also. Okay, they gives you encryption also like this. Okay, you can lock the content also if you want to lock the content. Okay, you don't want, you can lock your content also. It means after you apply the locks, you know, no one is able to add any content to this particular account. Okay, fine. So you can go for that. Okay, you can apply allow and deny also. Then you can go for access control options. Okay, so we can with the help of this access control, we can make one policy. We can add the person. Like imagine I have two persons, me and my friend. I want that we both of us able to add the media and add the assets in this storage, in this media storage. Okay, so we can go for that. Okay, so I can give the access, allow or deny. Okay, to the particular specified users. Okay, we can go for add a role assignment. We can go for that. We can do this also. We can check the properties also, our storage accounts, what we have. So this is my storage account, our media service account, AZ Media 1. So this is the account ID we have. Okay, this is the resource ID we have. I have storage name. They gives you all the information. Okay, my storage name, my storage account name. Okay, subscription name. Okay, you can, right now I'm using trial subscription. If you have a paid subscription, you can change the subscription also. Okay, so like this. So these are some options. With the help of these options, we can able to go for lots of things in this. Okay, we can go for live streaming also by click on live streaming. So if you want to go for live streaming, then you can go for live streaming also. Create a live event, okay, or add live event. Okay, so you can upload the live streaming videos also in this media services. Okay, so I hope you're able to understand this, how we can implement media services. First we need to create media service account. After that we need to create storage account. Okay, we need to accept the license agreements. We can create resource group also. All the media storage account and the store and storage account and media service account all saves in a particular resource group. Okay, and we can upload the assets. We can publish the assets. Okay, we can delete the assets also. We can upload more than two, three, four, five. Whatever videos you have, you can upload this like this. Okay, so I hope you're able to understand this video. If you have any doubt, any questions, please comment me on this video. Please like and share the videos, guys. Okay, thank you for watching, guys.